None of you saw that. None of you saw that.
All right. Give it up for Ethan.
I have apple juice in my pocket. And milk. Okay, hello, my name is Ethan Fay. I'm a freestyler, senior, obviously, and I'm a film student here. And so, Zenith, right? I was so excited. So, can any of you guys guess what my Zenith project was about?
Absolutely.
Star Wars!
Yeah, my Zenith. Woo! Guys, I love Star Wars. I love Star Wars so much. So, getting the chance to do this has been... I mean, I wanted to do a film about Star Wars my entire time here, and I never really got the opportunity. And then Zenith was like ahead of me, like, guys, this is my shot, this is my chance. So, I've loved Star Wars for a long time. This is me in my Halloween costume. Darth Vader is my favorite character. I do have two pictures of him up on my wall at home. and I've loved Star Wars for a very long time. There's little young Ethan in my little Stormtrooper sweater. There is a video of me playing tennis in a Darth Vader costume in third grade somewhere out there on the internet. If you find it, don't let anyone else know. So, table of contents. I'll talk about what my project was, kind of explain a little bit more into the detail of what it was, show you guys the project, and then we'll just do some questions. So, my project. I wanted to make something big. So I wrote an entire short film screenplay, and Mr. Taylor said, no. So, I went back to the drawing board, and I was like, what can I do? What could I spend my time learning and doing? Because I loved Exploitions so much. Exploitions was, you get to really explore, and I really wanted to do that for my Zenith as well. Because I've gained all these skills, but I still want to keep growing into learning. So really, Zenith is the culminative event of your freestyle process. And freestyle has always taught you to learn more, reach outside of your comfort zone. So that's what I did. I learned how to do VFX. I didn't like VFX starting this. I never found it believable. I didn't have the skills to be able to do it. And so I never wanted to put them in my films. But through this learning process, I've actually grown to love them a little bit. So, Star Wars plus VFX is kind of my Zenith project. So I created three short Star Wars films, like 30 seconds, a minute, each using different elements of VFX. I used a lot of VFX. I used green screening, rotoscoping, sound effects, sound distortion, camera tracking, overlays, CGI, and AI, actually. That was a really fun kind of last minute thing that I wanted to tap on at the end. This is the first short film. This is of the iconic double sunset of The New Hope. By the way, if you have seen Star Wars or know Star Wars, this presentation is going to be a lot more interesting than if you haven't. So, if you don't know, episode 4, the original Star Wars, Luke goes and watches the double sunset. It's this big dramatic moment. I was like, I want to do that. I want to create the two suns right there. I wanted to make it as true to the original film as possible. So it's almost a shot-for-shot remake, including timing. I also wanted to practice color grading, overlays, costumes, and masks for specific color adjustments. And I'll kind of talk about that in a minute. My second one, this one's really fun. The second film is a kind of a slight variation to something that actually happened in Star Wars. So there's like a meeting between Darth Vader and one of the commanders, and I kind of put my own spin on it. So it's, you know, we have the first one is almost a shot-for-shot remake. The second one was kind of a bit of my own thing. I practiced green screening, rotoscoping, camera tracking, masking, costumes, and CGI. The final one, though, is my own kind of creation. It was kind of a scene ripped out of the original screenplay that I wrote, and it was kind of a practice, because one day I do want to make that film. And I practiced CGI, rotoscoping, costumes, sound effects, and AI. So, this is where the fun begins.
Thank you.
Greetings, Lord Vader.
You're the Latin Falcon's escape.
Yes, yes, sir.
Do not let him get away.
Vader, Lord Vader, Lord Vader, Darth Vader, come on, Fal, we go back, when we were, an older one, well, not anymore, how about hot, with all the snow, and then you come in with your big cloak, and I was a trooper right next to you, huh, and we were blasting all the bad guys, come on, I know the Millennium Falcon got away this time, but it won't happen again, sir. I promise you. Please. Sir, I'm sorry. Sir. Please.
The time I used AI. Well, actually, okay. AI is about to turn everything on its head, right? Because I realized I left my light in shot, and I see it all, right? You guys probably didn't see it because I used AI to take it away. What? It was so quick. It was so easy. So that's my second key takeaway. It's the world of special effects is about to be turned on its head. So honestly, this might get a lot easier. Always meet your actors beforehand. I had a little bit of trouble with one of my actors who had hurt themselves the day previous. And so the first time I kind of was like, because I knew them and talked to them, but I didn't realize they had hurt themselves the day before. So I had to speed up the footage of them running. Never go in against a Sicilian when death is on the line, but that's neither here nor there. So, thank you. Any questions? Yes. I telephoto, I went straight to the beach and just, and then I, because we're shooting in 4K, you can zoom in even further, so I just, zoom in. It was really cool. And then to get the second sun, I shot it at two times. So I shot, it was one full continuous shot, and then I made it the shutter speed really high to make everything around it really dark so you could just see the sun. And then I overlaid that on top of the original footage to make the double sunset. Really, really cool. Yes.
Would it be acceptable to go against a Sicilian when death is on the line if you've developed an immunity to Iocane powder?
It would. Yes. Yes.
Which shot was the most, or which scene was the most difficult, and why?
Oh, okay. So honestly, technically, the green screening, the second one, was a nightmare because my computer was just going along very slowly. It crashed three times. As well as the getting the Millennium Falcon to kind of fly, it was me pushing my camera towards it and against it and animating all the special pew pew pew, and that was really fun. But the hardest one to film was the third and final one, because I just had such a limited time. I had a very short time limit to film it. Yes? No?
Yeah. Did you make the costume yourself?
So, I was talking with some friends about, oh, I have this really cool Star Wars film I want to pitch, and one of my friends was like, I collect Star Wars costumes. Well, my dad collects Star Wars costumes, and I was like, oh my god, you're a lifesaver. Can I borrow them? So I didn't make them, but I had a friend whose dad loves Star Wars, and so I don't think I could have done this without him. Like, he was the only reason why it got to look so good.
So I have two questions. First, for the music part and like the first movie, did you make that yourself to copy it, or did you?
No, that is the music from the original scene. I ripped it directly from it.
So your third film, where in the Star Wars like timeline does it take place?
The third one? Okay. So this is right after Order 66, but like a year after. So it's kind of like the last couple Jedi are being hunted down. And so it would take place kind of in that situation once the Jedi are hiding in the final Sith track them down. Any other questions? Yes.
How long did it take you to edit each of the scenes?
It took a long time. It took a while. Each scene took about kind of a week, not of straight editing, but kind of on and off, because I'm also working on senior narrative at the same time. It wasn't the most complex, but it was all new to me. So that was really fun. Yes, yes.
Which one was most fun to shoot?
Probably the third one. Because I loved when she goes and like, and I created like a distortion effect to create like the visual look of the Force, which was like the moment that kicked in, I was like, oh my god, that's so cool. And then you add the sound effect and it like, it sells it. And I was like, ah, that was so much fun. But also I loved making the credits. The credits were really fun as well. Yes. All right, any other questions? Yes.
Please.
Okay.
What program did you use to get rid of the light?
Get rid of the what?
The light. The what
is? Oh, that was After Effects. So After Effects, you can mask, subtract around like an area in the frame, and then it has a generative filter. So it's actually in the third scene when she's running and she's about to go do it. The light was like right in frame, and you could almost, unless you know exactly what you're looking for, you almost can't tell what it is.
So you use AI here. So I guess, do you think that like overall AI is a good thing for filmmaking or bad?
I am excited to see where this is going, because new technology will always spark new innovation. And so I think it's putting a lot more power into the hands of the indie filmmakers like myself and like yourself. So I'm excited to see what's gonna come out of it.
Well, the Force is very strong with you.
Yes.
Yes. Bravo.